She will help. Welcome to the jungle. Niranjan, stainless, spotless, free of all taints, blemish free. Such is the ineffable nature of our supreme reality. Prabhu, sovereign of sovereigns, Lord of Lords, Soul of Souls. Hey, Hara, you please remove me if my sense of I is a foolishly presumptuous and disturbingly nonsensical scribble upon the canvas of your limitless expanse. Shiva Hum, though I do make use of words, well, obviously, I'm still not attached to them, so I remain beyond them. For example, I use words like oneness, truth, love, infinity, eternity, God, Satan, angel, demon, divinity, etc., and the list goes on. However, I can honestly say that I have inwardly renounced truth, love, infinity, eternity, angel, demon, divinity, God, and yes, even Satan. Why and how so? Because too many hypocrites use these terms as they pose themselves as being so noble, so sweet, so unconditionally loving, when all these types are doing is lying. Lying to others, and not even to themselves, because such types subjectively know that they are full of putrid monkey shit. And creation? Don't make me fucking laugh, you deceptive rats of spit! Who spit on my very being. You get me angry, so I fucking... All of us are co-creators. So there is no way that any of us can individually create our own miracles. Because we are all composite parts of one endless being. Some playing the role of personified diseases that need to be eradicated so that such types may be purified of their bullshit amnesia, thus waking up for their fucking nonsense and waking up in some other realm where they can then learn how not to receive a burn from the solar light they dare to offend. If we assume that each of us are solely creating anything whatsoever, then all our talk of oneness is a lie. Because oneness implies interconnectedness, because no man or woman is a separate island. Even an actual island is not separate from the rest of the Earth's mass. It just appears that way. And those who believe in miracles and teach others to create their own miracles are fake and envious snakes in the grass. Because once any one of us truly surrender, yes, surrender to the only and real being that was, is, and always will be, and beyond even these limiting ideas of time, then one will know that the idea of miracles stems from a mindset that is lost in its own sea of whack and wannabe unconditional trash thoughts. Because once one really merges one separatist drop into that oceanic source, then the theory of miracles is revealed as the mute point it is. Believing in miracles, and even worse, that one can create one's own miracles, like the secret movement, which is merely comprised of materialistic ass wipes. So then, belief in miracles just means that one has not truly realized that the Endless One does not do miracles. He, she, them, it just is an ecstatically badass, inebriated with the wine of his, her, them, it, quantum evolving, maddeningly ambrosial, infinitely eternal spirit flow. Nobody creates their own shit, because we are all composites of each other. Therefore, we are all interconnected parts of each other. So then, creation is co-creational. Some are experiencing themselves as illusory viruses, and others innately and truly are blessed parts of our cosmic body. Those who are stubbornly remaining as personified in lying epidemics, thus insisting to be viruses, need to get kicked to another universe in the hopes that once there, they can finally get their shit right, truly open their hearts instead of their fucking legs. Or just fucking hump that box all the damn time, like rabbits on Viagra, and calling that bullshit love. Shiva hump. There's nothing wrong with sex, but it's the mentality. You people can judge however you want. We all do, so do I. Now, brother, you wanted to say something? Of course, now that I'm passing it to you, now people are going to think that I'm, like, culting you.
Yeah. All right? This is what I was saying. Facebook is a forum like that of ancient days, upon which I am witnessing the trial of Socrates, the diecasts convicting the philosopher of impiety, the impiety of failing to acknowledge the gods that the city acknowledges, and introducing new deities. I know that I know nothing. The words of the honest man echoes through eternity. And yet the repeating of his death eludes the minds of the so-called educated. It is indeed ironic, tragically so.
So, what? Can you elaborate on that, bro?
Yeah, man.
Have like a minute or so.
No, this is what it is. It's a forum. Facebook is a forum. It's a citadel. It's a city. It's a place where people gather together and share ideas and exchange and communicate. And there are those of us who have another perspective of things. And we are the minority. Therefore, the majority will have a hard time hearing what those who have to say something which is completely different, or maybe not completely different, but just another angle or another take, or just another way of looking at things, seeing things from another perception, another perspective, you're going to have a hard time being able to relate. And that's understandable. But don't put the same philosopher on trial to kill him or her or them over and over and over again with these false accusations.
There you go. Because people are killing with words. They think they're not killing, but they're killing with words.
They force their own...
Because words are thoughts, and thoughts are living energies. And that's what they're doing, and they claim to be so innocent. There you go. Shiva Om, brother.
Shiva Om.